Hello students, myself Milan Patel, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today's topic is all about lintels. So let's begin. So first of all, we will see what is lintel. Okay, a lintel is a horizontal member which is placed across the openings such as doors, windows, etc. to support the load of the portion of the wall situated above the openings like doors and windows. Okay. The function of lintel is just the same as that of an arch or one type of beam. Okay. However, the lintels are easy and simple in construction. For an arch, special formwork is required. Okay. So you can say lintel is easy in construction. Okay. Then the end of the lintels are built into the masonry, and thus the load carried by lintels is transferred to the masonry in jambs. You can clearly see in this figure, a load is actually transmitted into the masonry wall, okay, by means of jambs. At present, the lintels of RCC are widely used to span the opening for doors, windows, etc. in a structure. The bearing of lintel distances up to which it is inserted in the supporting wall should be the minimum of these three criteria. It should be minimum of 10 cm or the height of lintel or 1/10 to 1/12 of the span of the lintel. Okay, so you can easily calculate the bearing of lintel, or you can say the distance is up to which the lintel can be inserted into the supporting wall by this criteria. Okay, next is classification of lintels, or you can say various types of lintels. Okay, first type of lintel is timber lintel. Second is stone lintel, third is brick lintel, fourth is steel lintel, and fifth is reinforced concrete lintels. Okay, first of all, we will see timber lintels. Timber lintels are oldest types of lintels, though they are not commonly used nowadays except in hilly areas. So this type of timber lintels are mainly used in hilly areas. Okay, timber lintels are relatively costlier, structurally weak, and vulnerable to fire. Okay, so these are the one type of disadvantages of timber lintels. They are also liable to decay if not properly ventilated. Okay, so proper ventilation should be provided for the long lasting ability of these timber lintels. Okay, this figure A, this shows wooden lintel provided over the full width of wall by jointing together three timber pieces with the help of steel bolts. Okay, you can clearly see number of bolts are provided to fix this timber lintel. Okay, figure B shows wooden lintel for a wider wall. The lintel is composed of two wooden pieces kept at a distance with the help of wooden distance pieces. Okay, sometimes timber lintels are strengthened by the provision of mild steel plates at their top and bottom. Such lintels are also called as the flitched lintels. Okay, so this is called as timber lintels. This is basically used in hilly type of areas. Second is stone lintels. You can clearly see in this figure how stone lintels looks like. Stone lintels are most common types of lintels, especially where stone is abundantly available. Okay, a stone lintel consists of simple stone slab of greater thickness. It can also be provided over opening in brick walls also. Dressed stone lintels have good architectural appearance. Stone lintels may be used in the form of either one piece or more than one piece along with the width of the wall. Okay, so the actual width of the stone is actually the width of the wall. Okay, the depth of stone lintel is kept equal to 10 cm per meter of span, with a minimum of 15 cm. Okay, so this is how you can calculate or decide the depth of these stone lintels. They are used up to the 2 meter span. Okay, for wider span, stone slabs are kept on the edge. Okay, stone is very weak in tension. Also, it cracks if subjected to vibratory loads. Okay, so it is mainly used where compression type of loads are there. where there are tension loads or vibration loads are there, you cannot use stone lintels. Okay, hence stone lintels should be used with corrosion where shock waves are quite common. Okay, so this is called as the stone lintels. Next type of lintel is brick lintels. Let's see. Brick lintels are not structurally strong and they are used only when opening is small, less than 1 meter, and loads are comparatively light. Okay, you can clearly see in this figure the brick lintel is shown. Okay, a brick lintel consists of brick placed on end or edge as shown in this figure. Okay, a better way of forming brick lintel is shown in figure. The depth of brick lintels varies from 10 to 20 centimeter depending upon the span of the lintel. Okay, so based on that you can decide the depth of brick lintel up to 10 centimeter to 20 centimeter. It is constructed over temporary wooden centering. The bricks with frogs are more suitable for the construction of lintels since the frogs, when filled with mortar, form joggles which increases the shear resistance of end joints. Such type of lintel is known as joggled brick lintel. Okay, so brick having frog can be used in brick lintels. Okay, where loads are very heavy or span is comparatively more, lintels may be made of reinforced brickwork. Okay, this is how reinforced brickwork looks like in lintel. The depth of such lintel is kept equal to 10 cm or in multiple of 10 cm, like 10 cm, 20 cm, 30 cm, etc. Sometimes a 15 cm thick brick lintel may be obtained by using 5 cm thick tiles in conjunction with 10 cm thick bricks. Alternatively, bricks can be placed on the edges. Okay, the bricks are so arranged that 2 to 3 cm wide space is left lengthwise between adjacent bricks for the insertion of reinforcement, or you can say mild steel bars. Okay, the gap or joint is filled with 1:3 cement mortar. This is the proportion of cement mortar, where 1 is the cement part, 3 is you can say sand part. Vertical shear stirrups of 6 mm diameter wire are provided in every third vertical joints. Okay, so these vertical stirrups are provided at the every third vertical joints. Okay, and the diameter of this stirrup is about 6 mm. The main reinforcement provided at the bottom of the lintel consists of 8 to 10 mm diameter steel mild steel bars, which are crank up at the ends. Okay, so this is how you can construct the reinforced brick lintels. Okay, you can clearly see the longitudinal section and the cross section of these reinforced brick lintels. Okay, that's all about brick lintels. Next is steel lintels. Steel lintels are provided where the opening is large and where the superimposed load are also very heavy, or you can say the live load is comparatively very heavy. It consists of rolled steel joist or channel section, either used singly or a combination of 2 or 3 units. Okay, when use singly type of bin, the steel joist is either embedded in concrete or cladded with stone facing so as increases its width to match with the width of the wall. Okay, when more than one units are placed side by side, they are kept in position by tube separators. Okay, you can clearly see in this figure the tube separator, or you can say pipe separator, is shown. Okay, that's all about the steel lintels. The last type of lintel is reinforced concrete lintels. The reinforced cement concrete lintels have replaced practically all other types of lintels because of their strength, rigidity, fire resistance, economy, and ease of construction. These are the various advantages of reinforced concrete lintels. Okay, so nowadays this type of reinforced concrete lintels are mainly used in number of residential, commercial, other types of buildings. This can be used on any span. Okay, there is no span limitation in reinforced concrete lintels. Its width is equal to the width of the wall. Okay, the depth of RCC lintel and the reinforcement depends upon the span and magnitude of the loading. Okay, so if the span is more, loading is more, the depth of the RCC lintel should be more. Okay, the longitudinal reinforcement consisting of mild steel bars are provided near the bottom of lintel to take up tensile stresses. Okay, half these bars are however cranked up near the ends. Okay, you can clearly see the number of bars are cranked up near the ends. Okay, these are the main reinforcement bars. The shear stirrups are provided to resist the transverse shears. Okay, so you can clearly see stirrups in this section also. Okay, these RCC lintels are also available at precast units. Number of precast manufacturing companies develop this type of RCC lintels. You can buy these lintels and fix into your building. Okay, so this type of work can be also done in reinforced concrete lintels. For cast in situ units, which are quite common in number of type of construction of these lintels, formwork is required for the construction. Okay, so for construction at the site, number of formwork is also required to construct these reinforced concrete lintels. Okay, now let's see the RCC boot lintels. Okay, what is the meaning of RCC boot lintels? These RCC boot lintels are provided over cavity walls. Such a lintel gives better appearance and reduces the quantity of concrete. Okay, so these are the advantages of, you can say, RCC boot lintels. Okay, and this is mainly used over the cavity walls. Okay, however, the toe section of boot lintels should be strong enough to sustain the loads. You can clearly see in this figure the RCC boot lintel. Okay, the flexible DPC layer is provided above the lintel as shown in this figure. Okay, you can clearly see the black line is one type of DPC layer, which is damp, of course, which is exactly provided above the lintel. Okay, so this type of boot lintels are also used in cavity walls. Okay, so that's all about the classification of lintels. That's all about today's lecture. Thank you for watching.